Are you wondering how to turn your data into profits? Are your business and data strategies totally aligned? How does your data culture measure against the benchmarks to remain competitive in this modern world? Well, it's all here on today's episode. So get ready to transform your organization with data. And in this episode of Data Team Success with me, Ross Webb, which is brought to you in partnership with Amplitude, the best product analytics software I've ever used, we're going to be meeting Cosmin. And his expertise in data strategies and data culture isn't just a game changer, it's a game winner for businesses. Coming up in this episode, building a data culture starts here. Improving data literacy, why it's so important. The power of data strategy, then data pitfalls unveiled. You need to stay informed on this. And how to provide leadership that excels. Hey, Cosmin. I'm excited to tackle the importance of data culture, data utilization that gives business an edge, and of course, leadership that actually works. But first, could you sum up in your own view, what is a data strategy?
Yeah, look, I'm trying to be as simple as possible in this matter. I think the way I see it, it's more of a, you know, in-depth, well-articulated plan that aligns, you know, business objectives with how you collect, manage, analyze, and extract value from data to drive organization success. So it all starts from a well articulated also business strategy. This is the starting point.
That's great. So how do you separate a data strategy from a business strategy? What would be the steps of implementing your data strategy?
I think if it would be to start from scratch, you would take those, let's say, top three, top five objectives, and you would start to decompose them and try to think, okay, how can I look at my organization and think, okay, I need the right people that should be able to execute this. I need the right processes in order to execute this well, and I need the right technology to enable this execution. And it's all it's kind of wrapped around how to use data, how to hire the right talent, you know, the data talent, how to build the right processes that will assure, you know, good quality of data and good management of data, and what is the right technology for me to use on the current, let's say, maturity of my organization.
Now, how would an organization turn data into a data asset? Where would you start?
Yeah, so first I think it would be good to take a step back and think, what is a data asset and how people should define a data asset? And I have in my own definition, which is a data asset is more of a resource that is considered valuable because of its information content, because it provides a meaningful utility. In other words, it can be transformed into monetary value. It has a purpose, right? So data by itself, the collection of data point, without being contextualized, without being treated, without being managed, it's more of a liability rather than an asset. While you bring it all together, while you kind of contextualize it, this is where it can help you to, one, the basic thing, improve decision making. So it's more about internal focus. Second thing is you can wrap data around your product, so serve something to your users. Or ultimately, when you get to a, say, more mature instance, just sell information, anonymized data, and you can sell it outside directly, right?
So, elaborating on data assets, do you think enough organizations around the world understand how to look at data and consider it an asset, as you've explained?
No, not so much. Actually, it's most of the people that I interact with, they get super excited around data nowadays, because, you know, everybody's talking about data left and right, digital transformation, how do you use data in decision making, and so on. But the way they do it is they start to collect as much data as they want and as they can, but then they stumble upon using it and making it useful because they have too much information to play with. So no, they don't. Mo, you have, if you look in the market, yes, the ones that are doing it, they are doing it very well, and they are differentiating themselves.
You're totally right. Data literacy is a key component in actually utilizing data within an organization. What then would be the best way to build data capabilities within an organization?
I think the best way to start is with specific use cases. So you need to start with the problem. It's like in product, right? In product, you're starting with the problem of your user. It's the same here. You either start with the problem of user if you want to either wrap data around your product, or you can start with an internal problem if you want to improve your business outcomes. And thinking and articulating that problem statement well will help you decide what type of people you need. Do you need engineers? Do you need analytics engineers? Do you need data visualization specialists? Do you need data scientists? Do you need more product analysts in order to do all sorts of experimentation and A/B testing? What are the capabilities, like the people capabilities that you need in order to execute towards that problem? So you should start from the problem itself and try to get exactly the people that are needed for that use case. I'm a big fan of starting small and iterating and really growing as you have small wins and successes. Now, looking at the same problem, if you go on the processes side, you need to have the right workflows and governance for the data that will enable you to achieve your objective and to solve that problem. And clearly, one of the common things is you need to have the right processes to ensure data quality, right? So you need to have the data that it's accurate, that it's consistent, that it's complete, that it's relevant. So for that, you need the right processes because, you know, there's that saying of garbage in, garbage out. And if you don't have, you know, a good eye on the quality, it's going to be very hard to take the right decisions. And if you go on the technology side, I think technology democratized a lot. I think storage is super cheap these days. And there are so many options in the market that you don't need to build something extremely complex. There are lots of low-code or no-code technologies, so you don't need to invest too much in bringing a team of 10 to build your tech stack, right? You can do it with 2-3 people, just get it started, do something simple, and then as you have wins and as the team itself will learn along the way to solve problems, you will be able to build on them and to acquire more and more talent, improve your processes, and eventually at some point probably change technology as you're growing.
So then, what should a leader do to make their company stand out and use data correctly? And what do you see as some of the common pitfalls that you may have often come across?
I think in my experience, I saw two different customer segments, or let's call it target groups. Organization types. You have more of the, you know, incumbent, well-developed organizations that are going through digital transformation. So they are becoming conscious that data is a critical enabler for their success. And this is one persona. And here, what I usually experienced is that they really go full throttle on investment. they have the power, they have the money, as like, let's just put a couple of millions and solve this problem as soon as possible. And this comes with huge investments on building a very complex data strategy, starting to hire people more towards future needs rather than current needs. And I'll give you an example. Getting a head of data that it's more interested in data science and machine learning, while your data stack and your data maturity and literacy is very low, and you have low data quality, hiring that individual will not get you anywhere. Because first, that individual will be frustrated quite fast, and you'll not be able to offer him what he's excited about. And most probably, he's also not well equipped to solve foundational problems. He's more equipped into building data products. So that was one of the most common issue that I saw in well-developed organizations. They really go full throttle. We have the money to invest. We just hire the best head of data and he will figure it out. It doesn't work like that. It's not that simple. So you need to hire the right person for your data maturity, for your data literacy. And if you move to a different persona, which is, digital natives that kind of grew, they are more into a scale-up mode. They understood from the beginning that they need data for their success, and they are using it on a daily basis, but they start to hit a wall on their development. And what I saw there several times is, and I think I mentioned it earlier, is collecting all the data that is possible. I'm over collecting and over storing everything that is possible, because I may use it at some point. And then you have your analyst, you have a data scientist that get lost on what they can use. They change definitions along the way. The data point that was stored 2 years ago was a very different one compared with what you have today. And the market changed so much in the couple of years, especially with COVID, and not only, also in the previous years, like, it changed so much that a metric that showed a good performance 3 years ago today is not achievable anymore. And they start to get stressed about, okay, is this good? Is this not good? How I can look at different data points? And they simply stumble and they get blocked. So this is what I saw, like, the most common, and it appeared more than one organization that I worked with in these two different personas.
This is fascinating information for data leaders to consider. Before we wrap up, could you share your thoughts on how leaders can make the most impact to create a solid data culture?
Yeah, so I think what I was trying to convey is that you should hire a head of data, but you should hire it for your current needs first. It's not for your future needs. So hiring a CDO, it's a very good thing, but you shouldn't get the person that it's too excited about ML when you don't have foundational problems solved. And how can you build, a data culture in an organization? I think the first ingredient is to have leadership commitment. If the CEO and the C-level really understand we need data and they change their behavior into using data, into asking data for their decision making, that's going to be pushed in the organization. So that's the first step. And they also need to lead by example, right? As we know very well. Then secondly, yes, of course, you should have some sort of a data strategy. You need to show your organization that you know where you're heading. Have a business strategy and we have data that it's enabling that. This is how we're going to do it. These are our priorities for the next 2 years. And these are the action points that we will follow. Third, probably, but not equally important, is improve and promote your data literacy. So really helping your individuals to level up their capabilities around data. And very, very important at the end is how can you recognize and reward, you know, the right behavior? And how can you show this across the board to everybody? Okay, look, this team did very well because they use data. This is an amazing use case. Congratulations. How can we reward that? And you need to create this flywheel on which people will simply follow naturally, because it's becoming part of the day-to-day job.
Thanks so much for watching this episode. And connect with Cosmin on LinkedIn for more data insights. It'll definitely be worth your while. Now, keep an eye out on our next video in this series with Emily Reed, with data-driven insights to revolutionize your career and business. Until next time, from me, Ross Webb, thanks so much for watching, and thanks so much to Amplitude, the best product analytics software, in my opinion, for producing and helping produce this episode. Until next time, bye for now.